let your fire fall. Let me wait a minute. Somebody say, oh Lord, let your fire fall. One more time, somebody say, oh Lord, let your fire fall upon Global Life Church. Let your fire fall upon me. Let your fire fall upon Global Life Church. Somebody say, hallelujah. You see, the reason why people are afraid of the fire of God is because in Numbers 4 and verse 24, it says that our God is a consuming fire. One more time, somebody say, my God is a consuming fire. One more time, somebody say, my God is a consuming fire. You got to say it one more time again. Say, my God is a consuming fire. And so God. Somebody say, God is a consuming fire. You see, when God shows up, he shows up as fire. Somebody say, hallelujah. Where he sits and on his throne, it is fire. Somebody say, fire. Now, this fire, it is typical of earthly fire if you see a grass fire. Somebody say, uh-huh. But it has another dimension. Somebody said this fire has another dimension. This fire has another characteristic. This fire is the fire of God. Somebody say hallelujah. You see, he will let you see the fire like a grass fire or like a hillside fire. But this fire is a fire of God. Somebody say hallelujah. So our God, that's somebody say, oh my God, is a consuming fire. When his fire comes, he will let you see it. When the fire descended in Acts chapter 2, the people in Jerusalem saw the fire. Somebody say hallelujah. They saw the fire coming down as cloven tongues of fire. Somebody put your hands up and say, God, do it in our generation. You are so that you're in a casket. Come on, one more time. God, do it in our generation. If it mentioned before in the first century church, it can happen again. Do you really want it to happen again? Touch somebody and say, do you really want it to happen again? So this fire, this God's fire, has the characteristics of fire and the symbolism of fire. If you saw the tongues of fire coming down, you would say, that's fire. If you see the Holy Spirit's fire show up, you say, that's fire. Somebody say, hallelujah. If you see God's fire showing up, you say, that's fire. Somebody say, hallelujah. But it has another dimension to it. Tell somebody, say, there is another dimension to this fire. Oh, somebody say, hallelujah. And the enemy has been keeping us away from that fire. Somebody say, hallelujah. In that fire, there is power. Somebody say, power. Oh, somebody said, my God, it's a consuming fire. In that fire, the God kind of fire with the God characteristics of fire, it has a power in it. Somebody said, power. And then God has given these characteristics to the Holy Spirit. Somebody said, to the Holy Spirit. I can't hear sleeping. The church is alive. Come on. Come on. The church is upset. God has given the Holy Spirit's fire to the Holy Spirit to give out to me. And so this Holy Spirit's fire that the Holy Spirit has to give out to you. Somebody say, I need it now. Oh, somebody say, I need it now. Are we going to work this thing until the fire comes? Somebody say, hallelujah. What the church wants is the fire. Somebody say, fire, fire, fire. The church has been too cold, like a refrigerator, cool, cool, cool. And we come up with all kind of greasy grace doctrine. But we need to come back to the fire of God. Somebody say, hallelujah. Somebody prophesy with me and say, I need the fire of God. One more time, somebody say, I need the fire of God. Woo! One more time, somebody say, I need the fire of God. I'll tell you so we said. The fire has the symbolism. The fire of God has the symbolism of fire. Somebody say symbolism of fire. When you look at it, you're going to see fire. When you look at that the fire of God, it will get your attention and you will say, that's the fire of God. Somebody say, uh-huh. When you see the cloven tongues of fire coming down, you can identify and say, there's fire. Somebody say, uh-huh. When the fire comes in the church that the church so desperately needs, you will say, that's fire. Somebody say, uh-huh. But this is not like a bush fire. Somebody say, uh-huh. This fire is not like a grass fire. I can't hear you. Somebody say, aha. That's why the enemy has been knocking the door of the revelation of this God fire. I can't hear you. And this dimension of this fire, so that God, people don't enter into this fire. Ah, somebody say, hallelujah. in this fire there is power. Somebody said power. In this God kind of fire, it has the characteristics of power. Somebody said power. The power to raise the dead. Somebody said uh-huh. The power, once this fire comes in you, you can raise the dead. Somebody say, aha. Uh-huh. Once this fire comes in you, you can release this fire against sicknesses, diseases, and infirmity in your own body. Somebody say, aha. Uh-huh. Once you avail yourself for this fire to come upon you, it will stop diseases from coming inside of you. And that's why the enemy has been stopping this revelation from entering into the church. Come on. Put your hands together, God, we need this revelation this morning. Come on. Make yourself over and say, oh, we need. And listen, when this baptism of fire comes, it gives you power to deal with death. So somebody say, uh-huh. It will give you power to deal with untimely death. Yes, we all get up to die sometime. But listen, if you're under 90, you're not ready to go yet. Somebody say, uh-huh. We need the fire of God on the inside of you. Somebody say, fire. Somebody say, fire. So we need the fire of God to give us power to contend against the spirit of death. Somebody say death. And then to come up against the spirit of B-E-B-T, of bankruptcy. Somebody say, uh-huh. Because we are God is, he doesn't deal with penury. When God shows up, he deals with success. I can't hear the house up in here. When he showed up in Solomon's Israel, we had gold and silver like dung. Somebody say, uh-huh. You had the neighboring countries, we had peace in Israel. Somebody say, peace. When the fire of God comes, you see, after Solomon built the temple, and then he prayed. And when he prayed, the fire came. Somebody say, the fire came. Somebody say, he prayed. And then the fire came. When the fire came, the glory of God came. Somebody say hallelujah. The glory of God came into the temple. Somebody said, this is what the church needs. The church needs the fire of God. The church folks needs some intercessors. Somebody said, the church needs some. Put your hands up in the air and say, the church needs some intercessors. And so the church is too quiet in the intercessory department. And so therefore everything spiritual is hinges on our prayers. Anything that's going to leave earth to heaven and heaven to earth, you got to pray it in. Somebody say hallelujah. And at times you got to mix it with power-packed faith. Somebody say hallelujah. You see, there are two kinds of faith. There is praying faith. Somebody say praying faith. And you can pray for years and nothing happen. Or you can see a little movement. Then you can enter into another room of fasting prayer. Somebody say fasting prayer. Fasting prayer will bring lightning to your spiritual needs, financial needs, physical needs, mental needs. I can't hear the house up in here. Somebody said, when you start coupling and hooking up your faith, somebody said, my faith, in fasting, things begin to move quickly. Things begin to move what? Easily. Things begin to move suddenly. Somebody said, when I begin to fast and pray, things begin to what? A momentum happen. Somebody said, hallelujah. Say, God, let the momentum happen. One time, say, God, let momentum happen. I can't hear the house. Somebody said, let. Momentum. One more time. So let momentum happen. Woo! Somebody say hallelujah. Put your hands together and pray. Put your hands together and pray. Put your hands together and pray. Pray. Somebody pray in the spirit. One more time. I ain't nothing yet. Now come on. Shalala rabakoto. Just pray in tongues. Rebaba pray in heaven like another heavenly language. Somebody say hallelujah. Heaven has a language. Somebody say hallelujah. And somebody say the fire. I can't hear somebody say the fire. This fire is divine fire. Somebody say divine fire. This is not ordinary fire. Somebody say, I need divine fire in my life. Some like you are awake and say, I need divine fire in my life. Right, those who do things in the house, we need divine fire. Lift your hands up and say, God, I need divine fire. Release your divine fire in this house. One more time, somebody say, release. Your divine fire in this house. One more time, somebody say, release. your divine fire in the house. Ah, somebody say one more time again, release your divine fire in the house. Ah, somebody say hallelujah. So this fire is not ordinary fire. This fire has God's characteristics on the inside of it. This fire has God's charisma on the inside of it. This fire has God's glory on the inside of it. This fire has miracle working power on the inside of it. Somebody say hallelujah. And the church needs this fire. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say, my God, it's a consuming fire. When you touch this fire, you see he burns out. This fire consumes unrighteousness out of us. Somebody say hallelujah. Lift your hands and say, God, burn out unrighteousness out of me. I can't hear everybody. Everybody in the house, lift your hands. Say, God, there's no silent exorcism. Say, God, burn out the young ones, the men, the women, everybody, come on. Everybody lift your hands up. Everybody in the back, in the sound system, everybody lift your hands up. And the organ said, God, burn unrighteousness out of me. Let's say it one more time. God, burn unrighteousness out of me. Come on, say that to lift your sexuality. God, burn unrighteousness out of me. That's why the enemy wants to be on the river, on the bank. He doesn't want the church to have any power. Hey, the devil doesn't want the church to have any power. When God has given himself fire for you, and when he has given Jesus some fire for you, he has given the Holy Spirit fire for you. Ah, somebody say hallelujah. I don't want to be a Christian and hit the burning hell. I really want to get the fire of God. Somebody say the fire of God. One more time, somebody say the news. The fire of God upon me. One more time, like we are alive. Somebody say, let loose the fire of God upon me. I tell you, there's so many things that are coming out to distract you. Somebody distract you. And these are the best of times. Somebody say, these are the best of times. And do not let the enemy come into your life, your mind, your psyche, your spirituality, your sexuality, into demonism, cause you go to somebody else's house and the crazy stuff. This ain't the time for it. Somebody say, hallelujah. Somebody stamp your feet and say, those dumb days are over. Come on, come on, stamp your feet and say, those dumb days are over. I tell you, God's coming back for our church with power. Somebody say, God is coming back for our church with what? Power. Fire power. Somebody say, fire power. Oh, come on, somebody say, God is coming back for our church with what? Fire power. Our Numbers chapter 4, verse 24 said what? Our God is a what? Consuming fire. What was I consuming fire? He wants to release his fire power on the inside of you. He wants to release his fire light on the inside of you. Somebody say hallelujah. He wants you to be a light set on a hill. Somebody say hallelujah. Not hidden under a bushel, but a light. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say, I want to be light. One more time. Say, I want to be light. And so this fire is powerful. Somebody says fire is powerful. This fire brings resurrection from the dead. This fire, when it's released on the inside of you, it goes into your life to sickness, disease, and infirmity, to stress and to distress. And you attack that area, and it stays there like winnowing fire, and it burns it. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say, burn in me, Holy Spirit's fire. One more time, say, burn in me. And so this fire, when it's released, it consumes unrighteousness. Somebody say unrighteousness. It consumes evil. Somebody say it consumes evil. It consumes evil, the evil that's in the church. In 2 Chronicles 7, 14 say, the church got to present themselves before God first. Not the church pointing their 10 fingers out the wall, pointing to us first. We got to get right. Somebody say hallelujah. When we get right, St. Thomas will get right. Somebody say hallelujah. 50,000 of us. Somebody shout and prophesy to us of this time to get right. Walk and one more time practice. It's time for all Hazel to get right. Call your neighbors. It's time. It's time for the men of God to get right. It's time for the women to get right. It's time for the young women and young men to get right. Somebody's time to get right. Somebody say hallelujah. And so the enemy wants to keep us away from the revelation of the fire of God. Somebody shout to the preacher and say, no, not so. I tell you, this fire deals with the issues in your life. And when I believe that a little fire, we're going to release the fire in this house. Somebody say hallelujah. We're going to release it in the feet. Why? Because sickness is disease and infirmity. The folks say everything is attached on you. Your eyes, your nose, your belly, everything attached to your feet. So we're going to send it down there. Somebody say hallelujah. And get you healed in your eyes. Get you healed in your mind. Get you healed in your sinews. Get you healed in your kidneys. Get you healed in your liver. I can't hear. Get you healed in your heart. Ah, somebody say hallelujah. Everything attached to your feet. Somebody say hallelujah. So first we send the fire to your feet. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody lift your hands and say, God, send the fire early to my feet. Get all the tracks and all the sickness and disease in your body down to your feet. So we send the fire to burn up stuff in your feet. Somebody say hallelujah. And to deal with diseases in your feet. Somebody say hallelujah. The first thing when sickness comes on your body, with sugar, diabetes, and all those kind of stuff, the first thing is your feet goes. But the devil is a dumb devil. We're reversing it with the fire of God today. We send fire to feet, to feet, not to feet, but to fire to feet. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say, I send fire to my feet. I can't hear you. Somebody say, I send fire to my feet. Somebody say hallelujah. And so this fire of God consumes unrighteousness. Somebody say, consume unrighteousness in me. This fire of God, when it's released through us, it consumes evil imaginations. When they come to us, even in prayer, even in fasting, we say, no, I didn't buy that. I did not order that. Come on, let's practice it. I did not buy that, and I did not order that. That's not the imagery I want right now. The imagery I want is the angels, fire. I want to see miracles, signs, and wonders. Even as Christians, in your prayer and fasting, anyone bring crazy stuff into my mind. Old screens, dumb sexual stuff, the devil is a liar. That is coming quickly, release the fire. Woo! Come on, put your hands together, shout. Woo! Somebody say hallelujah. That's why the enemy doesn't want us. That's why the enemy is afraid. Up first of the baptism of the Holy Spirit, speaking with tongues as the Spirit gives utterance. Then the next door knock, we knock, and the baptism of fire. Somebody say hallelujah. Listen, and those of us who wants them to be filled with the Holy Spirit, go after it. Somebody say hallelujah. Go after it. It will preserve your life. It will preserve your mind. Somebody say hallelujah. It will undergird you. It will garrison you. Somebody say hallelujah. It will keep you sane. Praying the Holy Ghost. When you want to give your mental attack, pray the Holy Ghost. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say praying the Holy Ghost. That's good therapy. You don't have to go sit down in your therapist, psychotherapist office, pay $120 a day. You go to the psychotherapist, the Holy Ghost, begin to pray in tongues. Somebody say hallelujah. Pray in a strong, driving pray. Go to the beach, walk in the stand and pray. Let people say you're crazy. No problem. You're talking to the Holy Ghost. Getting your own therapy on. I can put your hands together and say it's about time. I get my own therapy on one more time. Come on, one more time, one more time. Shout, clap, say something. Ah, somebody say hallelujah. Ah, so for my God. Somebody say, my God. Put yourself and say, my God. Call your neighbor and say, all of us God. Personalize and say, all of us God. The Jesus God is a consuming fire. When he comes with symbolic characteristics of fire. We know that fire is here. Somebody say hallelujah. We can feel it. But this fire we are talking about, has the God characteristics on the inside of it. Somebody said, this fire is divine fire. The church folks needs this divine fire. Somebody said, I need this divine fire. Oh, come on. Somebody said, one more time, say it like you really believe it. Say, I need this divine fire. This divine fire will preserve your body. Somebody say hallelujah. This divine fire, once you ask for it, will put you back in your right mind. Somebody say yes. Somebody say, I need this fire. It will burn out the stuff that the enemy wants to burn in and put you back in your right mind. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody shout and say fire. One more time, fire. Fire, the fire of God with all of its characteristics, will come up against evil, unrighteousness, will come up against sickness. When the fire of God is released in your life, it goes into your blood vessels, your veins, go into muscles, travel through your body, through your veins, deal with issues in your life, transgenerational issues. As a big word, somebody said transgenerational issue, that which was transferred to you from your mama and them and your papa and them and all kind of side. Ha! The fire of God deals with that. Somebody say it's time for the fire of God to deal with transmigratory sicknesses and diseases in my life, transgenerational issues in my life. It means that stuff that were transferred, that you're not supposed to be carrying once you're in this kingdom, it's time to let them go. Release the fire of God against them. Somebody say hallelujah. Woo! Somebody say hallelujah. When the fire of God comes in, the fire of God comes to burn out poverty. Somebody say hallelujah. Oh yes. Somebody say yes. Somebody say release the fire of God to deal with poverty in my life. One more time. Church, that's awake, say, I release the fire of God in my life to deal with poverty in my life. Poverty issues, penury issues, penniless issues. Somebody say, poverty that was transmigrated to us through the curse of the law. Somebody say, hallelujah. So the fire of God deals with it. Somebody say, I tell you, want to burn it up like silver and gold, and then leaves a deposit of wealth on your mind. Somebody say, hallelujah. Then you say, God, burn wisdom on the inside of me. Your deal is that God give me wisdom concerning wealth, wisdom concerning prosperity. Somebody said, let the fire of God that has the characteristics of heaven, where there is wealth. Somebody said, well, put your hands on my right hand up. I said, I need this fire. Oh, we always need more money. You make your hand in that, help yourself. But we always come, put your hands on the pocket. Fire for prosperity. Fire. Come on, boom. Fire. Let's give you 7 times. Fire. Fire for prosperity. We've been so poor for so long that we're going to do something. Somebody say hallelujah. Ah, somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say fire. Fire. There's fire. There's consuming fire. Comes against unrighteousness. Comes against evil. It comes against sickness in your body. It is pinpointed in your body. When hands are laid upon you, or the fire is released, it goes to the area that is sick and start burning new organs on the inside of you. Somebody say hallelujah. And burning out the issues that are in your life. Somebody say hallelujah. Ah, yeah. Today we could experiment with that fire. And a few of you. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say, Who wants that fire? Who wants that fire? With sickness in your body, people with sickness. We're going to experiment and we're going to see if this thing really works. Somebody say, yeah. The consuming fire comes up against unrighteousness, evil, sickness, death, poverty, comes up against pain, always dragging in pain. Pain, somebody pain. Say, God, I need a fire. Lift your hands up if you're in pain. Say, God, I need your fire. The fire, fire. Come on, somebody say fire. Woo! The fire with the characteristics of heaven. Somebody say hallelujah. To burn. Somebody say to burn. To burn on the inside of me. Somebody say hallelujah. Burn out stress. Come on, say Holy Spirit fire. Come on, burn out stress. Distress. Spirits of infirmity out of me. And then burn out pain. As a matter of fact, put your hands where pain is. Put your hands right now where the pain is. Where the doctor said pain should be. And let's release the fire. Father, right now, release the fire. Release the fire to that particular area now. Everybody say release. Here comes the fire. Release the fire. In the house. Burn. Burn. God's fire burn. To drive out every sickness, disease, and infirmity. Somebody say now. In Jesus' name. Somebody said divine fire. Somebody said divine fire. This divine fire has substance. Somebody said this divine fire has substance. You can feel it. Touch yourself and say, when the fire comes, it has substance. In this God fire, it has the God substance. Somebody said God substance. It has the God kind of life. It has the characteristics of the fire from the throne of God. Somebody say hallelujah. Lift your hands up and say, God, I need this fire that has the substance of God in it. Faith is a substance. This fire has substance. It has life. Turn around sickness in your life and give you life. Oh, somebody say hallelujah. I look at the revelation of this fire. This fire, this consuming fire, burns up bad habits. Somebody say bad habits. You're saved, but you still have bad habits. Don't drink your rum and coke. Somebody say, You still have your bad habits of your 10 girls on the side. You still have your bad habit doing things in the kingdom, and then you go out and you sin. As soon as I finish preaching, you need the fire. Somebody say, you need the fire. You see, because everything you do, when you're going to a contrary fire in this house, you're going to mess things up in the house. In anything you do, the devil will tell on you. I say, keep that person carrying a contrary fire. Somebody say, I can't go up here and preach without just coming out of yalla yalla place. Somebody say, God forbid. Somebody say, I can't come from that point of view. Somebody say, neither can you, no matter what you do. Sweep the floor, wash the bathrooms, deal with those speakers. I need to come and take. And that jump. You say you can't sing at the door. Sit in the air. You can't. Somebody just say you can't. That's why we need the fire of God. Stop playing with the fire of God. When you say he has released it, a deposit of the fire of God on the inside of you, somebody say hallelujah. So some of you are too familiar. Just like you're familiar with the man of God. You're too familiar with God. You're too familiar with Christianese. So many people on the river, they're on the bank right now. When you leave here, you're down in the river of sin. Somebody say, too familiar with God and his power to forgive you. But watch out, we're talking about fire. This eight monkey fire. And today we're calling people to renew their covenant with God with this fire. That's why the enemy has been keeping us away from the revelation of the fire of the Holy Ghost. Somebody said, that's why he wants us to sort of have a religious service. We come, we sit down and we pat a cake, placate our spirit. Those days are gone. Somebody shout in the Holy Spirit, those days are. I feel God. Say the Bible tells it, those days. I need an emphasis in the church right about now. Somebody said, those days are long gone. They're on the river, on the bank. Christians are gone. Somebody say hallelujah. God is looking for brothers and sisters who are on fire. Not only the preacher, but he wants the lady, those who sit in his burger in the chairs, to be on fire. Somebody say hallelujah. He doesn't want to give a half fire. He wants to give you total fire. He wants to give you everything. Stop changing yourself. Somebody say stop. Start changing yourself. Somebody say hallelujah. Woo! Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say fire, fire. Put your hands up and say, I need this fire. Somebody say, I need this fire. And somebody say, thank God for the revelation of the fire. One more time, somebody say, thank God for the revelation of the fire. So Father, right now, open doors of wisdom concerning the fire. Come on, somebody say, open doors of the revelation about the fire of God. Let it not only be taught and preached, but God caused it to be caught and be manifested in our lives so we can be a burning and a shining light. Somebody prays that God caused me to be a bright, shining, a burning light for you. Oh, somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. So we understand that this is getting better. Somebody says it's getting better. This consuming fire that we found, that so many people are going to hear consuming, they want to run. But somebody said, you're consuming, you want to run. But the world runs from the consuming fire of God, but the church runs too. Somebody said, we run, I run. Somebody may not be your mom. Somebody said, I run. Woo! One more time, I said, I run to the fire. Oh, I run to the fire. One more time, give me a little sound. I run to the fire. I run to the fire. Come on, let's mix a little worship. And somebody say, I run. Breathe up, breathe up. I run.
I run, I run to the fire. One more time, I run, I run, I run. Mix it with worship, mix it with worship. Oh, I run, never. Lift your hands and just say, I run, I run, I run. I run all the way from the fire of God. I run to the fire. Blow my life, church. The men run to the fire. The women run to the fire. The young ones run. They run to the fire. All right, watch this now. Thank you. Let's hold us on. Hold us on. But the fire, somebody says, consuming fire. It gets better. Somebody say, hallelujah. It consumes bad habits out of us. Somebody said, it consumes what? You don't have to go see those therapists. You don't have to sit and rock in nobody's office. $125 per hour. Somebody said, the fire. Somebody said, send this consuming fire. It burns out bad habits out of me. Somebody said, it burns. Habit. I call the name. I said, it burns bad habits in another preacher. Oh, well, hey, so call your name. I'm preaching to myself. To somebody, say, hallelujah. Fire of God, let loose. And the organ, the preacher, everybody here. Somebody say, fire of God, let loose. Oh, I feel it. I feel it when I'm preaching to myself. Somebody say, fire of God, let loose. Fire, 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 fire. Woo! Somebody say, hallelujah. Oh, yes, somebody say, hallelujah. Fire. Fire of God, let loose. I don't want emotion. Somebody say, You saw my grandfather act, my uncle act, and I acting just like my father and mother. No, no, no. Up in here, you're gonna have different emotions. Somebody said, Infante. I hear nobody. Oh, you're jumping out there, bad woman. Somebody said, emotions. I have the fire emotions of God. Somebody said, hallelujah. I hear some of you. Somebody said, fire. This is your therapy. The fire of God will deal with issues in your life. The fire of God will deal with issues. That while you were minding your business as a young man or woman, somebody came and abused you. Somebody said, I'm not going to use your spirituality, your sexuality, your mind. Somebody said, And then you grew up and you're still acting in an abusive way. Somebody said, fire. Touch your head. Touch your head. Everybody. Everybody. Touch your head and say, fire, fire, fire. The fire of God comes against what my uncle did to me. The fire of God comes unto what my mother did to me. The fire of God comes to what my father did to me. Abandoned me, abused me, rejected me. So I say, fire, 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 fire upon my sexuality. Fire. Come on, somebody say, fire. Oh, this is what God in mass deliverance. Somebody know. We all say the same thing, but we're getting delivered. Somebody say, deliverance. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Somebody say, deliverance, deliverance. Somebody say, deliverance. Put your hands up, deliverance power. Come on. Somebody move to that. Come on. Deliver. Oh, God, release your fire. Release your fire. Release your fire. To bring for deliverance. Oh, release your fire. To deliver. Deliver us from procrastination. Oh, come on. Deliver, deliverance. Send your fire. To deliver us from a spirit of slumber. Somebody said, deliver me from the spirit of slumber. Come on, somebody said, deliver me from slumber. And deliver me from the spirit of laziness. Too lazy to pray. Too lazy to come to church on time. Too lazy to come out in the week. That's a spirit of slumber that has hit the church and caused it to be lazy. And then you bring up sons and daughters who are lazy towards the things of God. That's a spirit of slumber. Hey, somebody said a spirit of? Some of you are jumping off the wheel. Now you just don't know what it is. A spirit of slumber. Stopping you from pressing, from coming. Somebody said hallelujah. Oh, somebody said a spirit of slumber. Release the characteristics of a fire to the spirit of slumber. One more time, say, I release the characteristics of God's fire to the spirit of slumber. Some people just like it so. Somebody said, that's not the norm. Somebody said, that's not the norm. Moving your life lazy. Moving your life sleepy. Moving but your life deranged. I don't know what your auntie got, your mother got, you got. In the kingdom, it stops right here. And we exercise those dumb spirits. In the kingdom, it stops. Somebody ain't saying a blessing thing. So if you want to go home with it, help yourself. But in the kingdom, the preacher and the prophet say, in the kingdom, it stops right here. With the deliverance fire of God. The deliverance fire of God. Oh, yeah. The deliverance fire of God is all over the house. Fire. Deliver your people. Fire. Deliver your people. Fire of God. Deliver your people. Fire. Shekarabaka. Fire. Lord, tell me, we need so much fire. We need fire in this house. Oh, somebody say fire. Just go down. I tell you, I'm going to prophesy to scare you. We catch a fire, they catch a fire. Down the road, catch a fire. Somebody say, in place, catch a fire. Lift your hands up, lift your hands up, lift your hands up. Oh, come on, lift your hands up. Lift your hands up, you know. Say something. You don't need all the shout to one woman in the car. You shout to. Oh, you open your big mouth to God. Open your mouth, church. Open your mouth. So we're just silent. You're being silent when you're sitting. You're moaning. You come up in here and you're silent. Open your big mouth and say something. Open your mouth. I want to know, is it church? Like the day of Pentecost. When the fire came down. Come on. Help your Lord. If you're not too quiet, help your Lord. Open your mouth. Shut up, Rebecca. The fire first begins in this house. Send your fire. Oh, we overthrow the Chinese monkey fire. I hear the Holy Ghost. I'm well pleased with you, global and church. I'm well pleased with you, son, to overthrow sickness, disease, and infirmity, and what they have set in their calendar. We overthrow it from St. Thomas. Somebody scream as we overthrow monkey fire. We overthrow it, the historic monkey fight. They will have no bearing upon the church, no bearing upon the believers. Open your mouth, everybody. You don't want to read it. If you've never prayed before, you're visiting us, you've never prayed before. Come on, you repent to God, God in death. He's never heard of hearing you. God. He doesn't know to shout. He was here, so we can typify him. Somebody pray, come on. I want to pray, church. Pray for the fire. As you pray, come on. Ask for the fire to reach you from pain. Ask for the fire. Consuming fire to burn unrighteousness out of us. Ask for the consuming fire to burn evil out of us. Ask for the consuming fire to burn sickness out of you. Ask for the consuming fire for those who are dead, Lord, to burn the spirit of death out of you. Burn the spirit of poverty out of you, God. Burn of pain. Release the fire. Drive out pain by your fire. Drive out bad habits by your fire. Oh, this one I didn't get to, but drive out old age. The fire of God drives out old age. They give you a good plastic surgery overhaul. You look like in your old age, you look young. Come on. Give my seniors an overhaul. Tighten up, knock on wrinkles. All my seniors, lift your hands up. Knock on wrinkles. None of my seniors got wrinkles. No wrinkles to twinkle. I hear the Holy Ghost put a rhyme to that. No wrinkles to twinkle. No wrinkles to twinkle. No stretch their flesh. stretched afresh, given brand new, epidermal flesh, brand new, epidermal flesh. And then this anointing, this ain't for the skinny ones. Don't you want to lose some weight? Put your hands on your belly. No, this ain't for the skinny ones. If you want to lose some weight, put your hands on your belly now. This ain't for the skinny ones. Because some of your clothes are going to drop off. In the name of Jesus, we release the fire. You just say, say what size you want to drop to. Say what size you want the fire to burn fat off of your waist. Whatever you want to. In the name of Jesus, you're going to say your size. Say your size, Lord. Say your size. Say your size. In the name of Jesus, with this anointing, fire, we anointing. That we learn from Brother McKay, we release the fire of God right through this congregation. Those who want to drop fat, they have already declared, let the fat burn. With the fire of God, let the fat burn. Everybody say, let the fat burn. With the fire of God, one more time, put your two hands on your desk and let this belly fat burn. Oh, burn. Burn when you're burning, burn. Remember those profundary. Set. Set. Set our life in order. Set our bodies in order. Somebody say hallelujah. I tell you, let's worship it, worship it. Together, I have about 3 to 5 people that really want the fire of God. We have about 3 to 5 people who want the fire of God. Come, don't come to waste my time. But if you want the fire of God, if you want the fire of God, you have about 3 or 5 people that come with strength. I need somebody to stand behind them quickly. We are my men. We are my men. We are my men. We're not afraid of the fire. We are my men. We are my men. Stand by her, Silver. Stand by her. Stand by her. But it's going to be hot. Worship, worship. Worship, church. Yes, go ahead. Worship, 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 worship. Worship, worship, worship. Put your hands over behind everybody here, please. Be sure we have men behind everybody. Be sure we have somebody, have a woman, who got somebody behind. Let your fire fall. God, just put your hands up, put your hands up. And act like you're hungry. This fire is going to come. And you tell me what you want to come. You tell me what you want this fire to do within you. Let the fire drop upon this ice, Nicholas, I saw. Everybody say, let your fire drop. There comes the fire, God. Fire. Everybody say, fire. Everybody stretch your hands and say, fire. Fire. In your feet. Fire. Fire. To be with this fire. Fire. Fire in the feet. Fire. Maybe something going to release fire. Fire! Woo! Fire! Fire! Fire in your feet. All right, fire. Get ready. Put your feet together. Don't you fall, but put your feet together. Fire! Release the fire. Every mental sickness or disease I want to put you into your good life. We send the fire of God in your feet. To be the fish. Every vessel of your feet shall track from the Lord.
This is holy ground.
Walk upon you. That transmigratory generational sickness is really quality.
This is holy ground.
In your retirement age, you'll have more money over count. I bring an ideas to you. Ideas. He is dealing with contention. contention in your feet.
His limit,
yes, it will hit. His limit accumulating sickness, disease, and in your feet. Deal with that spirit, the contending with in your feet.
Release
it now. Fire. Here it comes, here it comes. Everybody say fire, fire, fire. Fire, then release. Here it comes. Suddenly.
Fire.
Fire, fire. Somebody say fire. Consuming fire. Everybody say consuming fire. Somebody say we're afraid of the consuming fire. Well, this is your turn. Let's take it. Let's take it. How far is up? How far is up? How far is up? How far is up? Such miracles so far. To deliver the absence of your husband. Just to remember him. But you would not weep. As in the death. But then what he will say. I have a brand new life for you. And that situation, where is that air situation that you have, put your hands in, put your hands in right there. Your fingers, fingers. No, that's Eddie's anointed finger. With your hands. This one will be good, no, that's okay. Come out of here. Come out of here. Is it there? A hammer? A hammer? Do you know what's that? It is what? Okay, pinch. Pinch, pinch, pinch. Okay, but you're going to do it. Go ahead. If you want to come to this church, that pinch says you're going to go. Okay, you want to be a part of this grand miracle right now. We send the fire of God today. I think the left hand. We send the fire of God. The left hand. Everybody say, we send the fire of God from the left hand to deal with that pitch sensitivity. She will let the red fire of worship, spring, preaching. That's over. This thing will be designed in first. In the name of Jesus. That tormenting spirit that has a pitch sensitive look. Pack up your bodies. Pack up your suitcase. Pack up your demonic activity. Leave! Come on, everybody, leave! She hears now correctly. She hears now correctly. Everybody said, oh, she hears now correctly. Release the fire of God. The fire. Here we go.
Fire.
Everybody said, oh, minister.
Release.
Fire. I feel it, I feel it. That's it. That's
a fire.
Fire, 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 fire.
Release the fire.
Yeah. The fire.
Release the fire.
Yeah, the fire, the energy of God.
Release the fire.
That's it, that's it. That's it right there. The fire, the fire, the fire, the fire. That's it, that's it.
Release that's it, that's the
it.
Fire.
That's it, fire, fire.
Release the fire. Release the fire.
Release the
fire.
Release
the fire. Release the fire.
The Holy Spirit saying, don't worry about your educational status, because in the kingdom, it doesn't give you educational status. It comes with one who is dedicated to God's word and in prayer. And if you're serious to be in this kingdom, begin to read the word of God.